Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. Today I'm doing a video all about how I balance school, work, YouTube, a social life, and everything else I have going on in my life. I know a lot of you guys have the same struggles that I do, which is probably why this was one of my most requested videos. So I am really excited to show you guys my tips and tricks for balancing a bunch of things. So just to kind of put things into perspective and give you guys an idea of what I have on my plate every week, I'm a full-time pre-PA student. You guys may or may not know, but I work part-time in the ER as a tech, and I work 2 12-hour shifts a week, so that's pretty much 2 days out of my schedule that I can't get back because they're 12-hour shifts. So from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. I am at work and I can't do anything else. So I pretty much have 5 days to balance everything else. I upload new videos on YouTube 1 to 2 times per week. I've been super consistent with this, so I'm very proud of it. I think my little system is working out. I try to go to the gym 2 to 3 times a week. And then I also have a blog where I work with brands and I do some Instagram influencing, so I have to make time to take pictures for that and respond to emails with brands and all that stuff. And then of course, I'm in a relationship. I have a family, so I try to make time for those things too. And the hardest part is finding balance. So today I'm sharing with you guys my top 5 tips to help you balance a really busy lifestyle. My first tip, and this will always be first, is to get yourself a planner. You don't have to get the same planner as me, but I do use the Day Designer, and I love this planner. I have actually switched so many different planners this semester alone, though, so like, don't take my word for it. I just really like trying out new planners, but I will never not use a planner because I find it extremely important to write everything down. It's the only way to get it out of your head, and it's like de-stressing to know that you have it written down. You're not gonna forget anything. I write all my deadlines down for school. I write all the days down that I have to work. I write down when I have plans for dinner with friends, family. Literally everything goes in the planner, and then I just open it up and I know what's going on. A lot of people keep everything in their head, and that stresses me out to no end. I don't know how you can do that. But if you're not someone that likes writing things down, but you do need a way to know when you have things coming up, try out Google Calendar, because I use Google Calendar too. I think it's a great way to digitally plan out everything that's going on in your life. My second tip is to be strict with yourself. This takes a little bit of training, but I've had to really teach myself to tell myself no, to force myself to study, to stop making up excuses when I come home in between classes, like, no, you're not taking a nap, it doesn't matter if you're tired. Like, I've had to really learn to just be strict on myself, and that's the only way that I'm able to accomplish so much during the day. A lot of you guys comment on my College Day in My Life videos, and you're like, oh my gosh, like, how do you do all of this? How do you look like you have your life together? And I'm not perfect. I mean, like, I do take naps occasionally. I do have days where I don't get as much done. But as long as I'm doing the things that I'm telling you guys now, like, my weeks are productive and I'm happy and I feel good about my life. And just remember that, like, at the end of the day, you decide what you get done. So if you're lazy and then you're mad because you didn't do well on a test because you didn't make time to study, that's on you at the end of the day. Like, you have to be that harsh with yourself, because that's what I do. My third tip is to plan out your day the night before. This is a really, really great tip, and it's also just like good for the mental health if you just sit down at night and instead of playing on your phone, literally write a to-do list. If you write down everything that you have to do, then the next day you already know. There's no question, there's no time to sleep in, because you already wrote down that as soon as you wake up, you have this, this, and this to do. So it just kind of leads to productivity if you write a to-do list. And this goes back to the second thing, that you just have to be strict with yourself, because if you write something down on that to-do list, then you need to tell yourself, I'm gonna do it. If I wrote down that I'm gonna study my flashcards, or I'm gonna read the chapter before class, you have to do it. My fourth tip is to learn how to say no. And I don't just mean saying no to friends when they want to go out and party the night before a test. Like, obviously that's a typical college thing. But if you're like me and you don't have any friends, then you don't really run into that issue. When I say learn how to say no, I really mean like telling yourself no. So sometimes I come home and I'm tired. Obviously I have a lot going on. I have to tell myself no. I'm not gonna lay down on the couch because I know that's a bad decision. I know that I'm gonna get tired and it's gonna lead to me being unproductive the rest of the day. So I've had to learn how to tell myself no. Same thing with if your boyfriend or friend wants to come over and they wanna go watch a movie together, whatever the case is, you just have to learn how to set limits for yourself and tell yourself no. If you have things to do, if you have a test to study for, if you know you have to work the next day, you know, those commitments come first. So it comes back to the whole thing, which is prioritizing, which is a skill that, like, it takes a while to learn, and I feel like it changes throughout your life what your priorities are, but you've got to figure out what those priorities are and put them in order. I'm kind of mean to myself though, because sometimes when I like to screw around and not get my work done and be super lazy, I force myself to think about how I would feel if I failed my exam when I'm just like trying to be lazy, and that like almost scares me enough into getting my butt up and studying because I don't want to do poorly. I'm trying to get into PA school, if you guys don't know, so I need to get pretty much A's in every subject that I take from here on out. So it is literally crucial that I have time management down to the T. And my fifth and final tip for you guys is time blocking. Time blocking, I don't use every single day. I feel like I have a good enough management on my system where I don't have to write down every single hour, but if that's what it takes for you, do it. When I have a lot of things that I'm like cramming for an exam, say I had a not as productive week as I should have and I had an exam on Monday and I'm starting to study on Friday or Saturday, I will use time blocking like crazy. It is an amazing tool. You don't even have to have a time blocking planner. You can literally just get a piece of paper out, write the hour that you're waking up all the way down to the hour that you're going to sleep, and then you're just going to block out every single hour of the day and what you need to get done. The key to time blocking is actually following it though. You can't just write down that at 3 o'clock you're gonna do this and then you don't even do it. Super important that you follow it if you're gonna write down your time blocking stuff. But I find it super helpful if I'm cramming, because sometimes happens to the best of us. I mean, I'm taking multiple classes. I have like a bunch of deadlines and a bunch of things to do all at once. So in order to enhance my productivity, I time block. And that just ensures that I get everything done that I need to get done. I might even do a whole separate video about cramming for like exams, because I feel like I have a pretty good system if I'm like last minute studying and I have like a bunch of different material to cover, but that would be a whole nother video. So that's pretty much it. That is how I balance work and school and everything else going on. It is definitely a major challenge, I'm not gonna lie. I was not blessed with parents who paid for my college, so I have no choice but to work and go to school to support myself. I know there's a lot of you guys out there like that too, so you have to find balance to do things that you enjoy doing as well as school, as well as work. It's a constant struggle, but I really hope that these tips helped you guys. If they did, then make sure you give this video a thumbs up. Leave a comment below if you guys have any other tips or things that you like to do for time management and productivity. And if you're not already subscribed, be sure to click that subscribe button, and I'll see you in my next video.